Burnaby Loheed.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. It's the first hour back for the fall session, and I guess the gloves will have to come off earlier than I thought. I would like to thank the member opposite for her comments. It is important that we celebrate the successes and achievements of the small business sector in our province. And I would challenge the member to have a consideration for the current ways of today's policies that we can better improve for support of our small businesses. There's only so much we can talk about the 90s. So further to my remarks earlier, I would like to elaborate more on the ways that we can be more sensitive to the unique needs of the various types of small businesses under the small business umbrella, and how we can also be more specific in our support. So as far as today's policies go, the government's preoccupation on the liquefied natural gas sector is no news for the British Columbians. And as we are well aware, has caused for concern by both industry experts and community stakeholders, as we saw many other valuable drivers of our economy inflicted with growth limitations and even decline, like arts, technology, film, science. Many of these are small businesses right here in BC. So be it the Kinder Morgan Trans Mountain pipeline project or the proposed LNG facility, the government-subsidized corporate operations are imposed on our communities without sufficient conditions to support the local small businesses for materials and services. My colleagues and I on this side of the House has called on the government for more local purchasing policies that would promote BC foods, support BC orchidists, have more local foods, for example, served in BC hospitals and schools. We believe that our long support for these ideas has forced the government to move in that direction, and we'll continue to press them to go further. We are also closely watching the government's effort to simplify the procurement process to make it easier for small businesses to apply for government contracts. In general, the liberal practice has been to negotiate large and complex contracts with large out-of-province companies, a practice we've argued has not wasted not just billions of dollars of taxpayers' money, but has also cut out and minimized participation of many local businesses, especially construction contractors. So, I'll take this opportunity to continue urging the government for fair and competitive procurement practices that respect the taxpayer dollars and include all BC opportunities. It is also time for the government to finally step up and, like the five other Canadian provinces already have, and introduce a legislation that will better protect the franchisees in British Columbia. My colleagues and I supported Bill M219, introduced this spring by the member from Victoria Beacon Hill, for regulation of the sales, improved disclosure practices, and more legal rights for the franchisees. So, during this Small Business Month, we would like to our commitment to look out for the best interests of BC small business, who make up the backbone of our economy. Thank you.